Good evening, you're watching Orissa Vision TV. I am Priyanka and welcome to News at 7. Delhi Burari case hits back and lots more in this segment. Let's go to the headlines first. Bihar nightmare still continues. Muzaffarpur shelter home girl says they were stripped, spanked for refusing sexual demands. Temple in UP purified with holy water after BJP lawmakers' visit. Burari repeats, family of 7 found dead in Ranchi, cops probe murder-suicide plan. US elevate India's trade status to NATO-level ally. Move to boost access to our defense tech. Heavy rain slashes parts of Kerala. Disaster team and forces on alert. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi asks people to give ideas for his Independence Day speech. Police use tear gas to quell violent Maratha protest in Western Maharashtra. 30 buses set ablaze, 100 vehicles vandalized. Rohingya issue rocks parliament. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said states have the right to deport illegal migrants. Aam Aadmi Party, TMC and Samajwadi Party MPs are protesting against NRC issue outdoor of parliament. Dharmendra Pradhan says insurance companies have been directed to start disputal of claims immediately. Orissa government has decided to launch its own food security scheme. The state will spend of around 220 crore more in the first 6 months.
Investigators suggested that 34 of the 42 girls examined so far were found to be sexually exploited. Two mentally unstable girls could not be examined so far. To add more horrific details, some inmates have spoken to the police investigators that they were used to be taken to the roof of the third-storied building, stripped naked and spanked if they were refused to submit to sexual demands. The girls even told authorities that songs with double-meaning lyrics would be played in the evening at the shelter homes. Referring to two shelter home staff as aunties, the girls alleged they would beat them if they did not heed the directives. However, the girls said the aunties were scared of Sir. 10 of 11 accused, including Brajesh Thakur, who ran the NGO operating the shelter home, and 7 women have been arrested so far. Former chairman of the district child welfare committee, Dilip Kumar Verma, who being the 11th accused, is absconding. A local court has issued a proclamation against Verma. The NGO running the shelter home in Muzaffarpur was blacklisted and the girls were shifted to shelter homes in Patna and Madhubani. A temple and ashram in Uttar Pradesh, Hamirpur district, were purified with waters of the Ganga after a woman leader of Bharatiya Janata Party broke a tradition and entered the campus to pray. The BJP's MLA Manisha Anuragi visited the ashram on July 12th for a darshan, where women are allowed to pray only from the outside. They said that the heavy rainfall currently lashing the state is a result of the purification of the ashram and the idol. Some devotees said that the region faced a drought 4 decades ago when a group of women performed some rituals inside the temple. In a case that brought back the horror of 11 deaths in Delhi's Burari, 7 members of a family were found dead in Ranchi's Arsande area. In Delhi's Burari, 11 members of a family were found dead in what is believed to be a ritual gone wrong. The dead in the Ranchi house were identified as Sashi Kumar Jha, a retired railway employee, his wife, along with his son and daughter-in-law and their grandchildren. The body of the 2 of the sons were found hanging from the ceiling along with 5 other bodies wrapped in a blanket on 2 joint mattresses in 1 room. The second son was found hanging near the bed in the adjacent room. Police said 2 upturned wooden stools were also found in the rooms. Prima facie investigation reveals that it seems the brother had hanged themselves after killing other 5 members. Other angles are also being investigated. the United States on Monday elevated India's status as a trading partner to equal that it has accorded largely to its NATO's allies, mostly for the purpose for speeding up the sale of high-tech defense and non-defense products that are otherwise subjected to strict controls and licensing. The move will reduce the number of licenses needed for US export to India, which means India can get easy access to the latest defense technologies. It would also mean a leg up for the foundational Comcast agreement, which the US is keen to take India to sign. The Communication Compatibility and Security Agreement is one of the three agreements that the US has its closest military allies and will allow the installation of high-security US communication equipment on defense equipments being sold to India. Though India has concerns on giving the US access to sensitive military communication if it signs the agreement. District authorities have issued an orange alert in Idukki Dam, some 250 kilometers north of the state capital, after water level in the Idukki Dam touched the brim. The water level in the dam touched the brim after 25 years as heavy rain continued to pour many parts of Kerala. Idukki district authorities said they will open sluice gates. Many people have already been evacuated from the areas, with the water level in the Idukki dam across the Periyar River nearing its maximum storage level. The state government called the army and navy on alert. A team of Disaster Management Control Force is also camping near the district headquarters. Med officials said Idukki received 192.3 cm rainfall this year, which is at least 49% more than what the hilly district received last year. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday asked citizens for their ideas and suggestions for his speech on Independence Day at the Red Fort in New Delhi, a practice he has been following since the last few years. People have already started suggesting the Prime Minister the issues he should address in his speech. Some want him to speak about the growing incidents of sexual assault and harassment of girls and women, while others want him to talk about the reservation caste, fake news, among other things. Our reporter Ashok Kumar Sahu updating us that there was an accident, a severe accident taking place at Katak Chandbali Road near Nishchand Kohli. The deceased found to be Ramchandra Mahanto. As a protest to the above, the locals tried to block the highway and the investigation is still carried on. The Maratha reservation row, which seemed to have ceased, once again escalated on Monday in Pune as protesters torched several vehicles and vandalized buses on Pune-Nasik Highway. At least 30 buses were set ablaze and more 100 vehicles were vandalized by the protesters. These violent protests escalated soon after a peaceful Rasta Rok protest was organized, which eventually turned violent. Police were forced to fire tear gas shells in the air and some places to shell the protest. Protesters in Chakan attacked policemen and damaged at least 100 vehicles. Maratha protesters blocked the Pune-Nasik Highway for at least 4 hours on Monday morning, despite leaders from the protesting Maratha organization appealing to the community members did not indulge in violence. Monday's protest came after the day after Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis reiterated his government's commitment to reservation of Marathas and also assured a delegation headed by former Chief Minister Narayan Rane and withdrawing cases against agitators. The matter was raised in Lok Sabha on Tuesday by Sena MP Arvind Ganpat Sawant, who raised the issue of Rohingya in the House. Responding to Sena MP Minister of State and Home Affairs Kiran Rijiju said, "Rohingyas are illegal immigrants and government is not responsible to cater to them." Even Home Minister Rajnath Singh spoke on the Rohingya issue and said that there is an advisory has been issued to states to monitor Rohingya movement and have been asked to send information on the population of Rohingya in the state to central government, post which the government will speak to Myanmar government and ensure the deportation. Opposition TMC today forced adjournment of the proceedings in the Rajya Sabha till noon over the issuance of non-inclusion of over 40 lakh people in Assam's National Register of Citizens. TMC leader Derek O'Brien wanted his notice under Rule 267, which calls for setting aside of the day's business to take up issues pressed, to be taken up. TMC leader, who has yesterday too led the protest that saw Rajya Sabha proceedings being adjourned without transacting any business, vociferously protested from the aisles. The delay in payment of crop insurance claims farmers was discussed with Goel in presence of senior officers of the Finance Ministry and Insurance Company. Union Urban Tribal Minister Jwal Oram also attended the meeting. As per Dharmendra Pradhan, in a meeting with the finance counterpart, Piyush Goel in New Delhi said, claims having no dispute will be disbursed within 2 to 3 days, while those over with insurance companies have raised objection will be resolved in 3 weeks' time. Orissa government has decided to launch its own food security scheme to cover poor, distressed and eligible beneficiaries left out from the schemes on the National Food Security Act. A proposal in this regard was approved by the state cabinet presided by Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik here on Monday. The state will spend Rs 220 crore more in the first 6 months. The distribution of rice to 25 lakh beneficiaries in the first phase will start from October end. And that's all for this bulletin. Before wrapping up the show, let's review the headlines once again.
Bihar nightmare still continues. Muzaffarpur shelter home girl says they were stripped, spanked for refusing sexual demands. Temple in UP purified with holy water after BJP lawmakers' visit. Burari repeats, family of 7 found dead in Ranchi, cops probe murder-suicide plan. US elevate India's trade status to NATO-level ally, move to boost access to our defense tech. Heavy rain slashes parts of Kerala. Disaster team and forces on alert. Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi asks people to give ideas for his Independence Day speech. Police used tear gas to quell violent Maratha protests in western Maharashtra. 30 buses set ablaze, 100 vehicles vandalized. Rohingya issue rocks parliament. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said states have the right to deport illegal migrants. Aam Aadmi Party, TMC and Samajwadi Party MPs are protesting against NRC issue outdoor of parliament. Dharmendra Pradhan says insurance companies have been directed to start disputes of claims immediately. Orissa government has decided to launch its own food security scheme. The state will spend of around 220 crore more in the first 6 months.
Keep watching Orissa Vision TV. Thank you and a very good evening.